Nothing stops the gamble. Nothing stops the gamble.
Nothing stops the gamble.
What up? It's the Trooper. Guess what day it is, y'all? Guess. Monday? Wrong. Well, actually, it is Monday, but today is the day I'm going to pick up my first two orders, 70 bags of coffee, and I'm getting ready to start shipping that stuff out. If you ordered Go Gamble Blend Mark II, it's shipping out on Monday, and what else? What else is there to tell you? The coffee was ready on Friday, but the labels weren't ready. The printer didn't have the labels ready. So now we're ready to go. So hope you love the coffee. I'm gonna go get the coffee and I'm gonna come back here and we're gonna do a packaging and shipping operation. And then, well, poker. What else? Well, here you go, the new Go Gamble blend. I got a lot of orders to ship out. It's like 10 till 4 p.m. Let's get it going so we can get this done and go play some poker. Yo, I can't tell you how much it means to me that you guys would order this coffee. It's what I'm drinking every day, every morning, every afternoon, every night. I dig it, I like it, I love it. It's my coffee now. And you guys ordering the Go Gamble Blend Mark II makes me really happy. Actually, let's look at that label a little more closely, make sure it's exactly right. We got the organic, the Trooper 97's Go Gamble Blend Mark II. All right, I'm gonna get an exact weight for these boxes. I'm gonna order shipping labels, I'm gonna print shipping labels, I'm gonna tape shipping labels, I'm gonna drop these shits off at the USPS. And yo, if you don't mind, everybody out there who ordered this coffee, let me know what you think of it. Give me some feedback, let me know if you like it. It's not exactly the same as the old Go Gamble blend, but it's really good, I like it a lot. And yeah, what else can we say, what else can we do? Let me know. Wow, that's a lot more work than I thought it was gonna be. I still gotta take all those boxes to the post office. I hope Vegas is still open when I'm done. It's one of those days. One of those strange days in which I get up, have a plan. The plan includes coming down to the strip, getting involved in a poker game with the intentions of padding the roll a little bit. And now that I am here, now that I am on the strip, I don't want to play. I don't want to play poker. See if I can get run over by this truck. Then I won't even be able to play poker. All right, I didn't get run over by the truck. Good, good, good. But such a weird feeling. I almost went to a Dirt Dog, but I decided I want one of these, what is it, a Hero? So I went to the Mediterranean Istanbul place. There was no one in line. Someone was paying at the other window. And I stood there. The dude was standing in there texting. I mean, he's 3 feet in front of me, facing me, texting. I know he saw me and he just let me stand there. So I stood there staring at him until he finished texting. It was a good 45 seconds, believe it or not.
Then he dropped the phone and said, "Hey, how you doing?" And I just turned around and walked away. Slow roll action. So I came back to Dirt Dog. First of all, the Dirt Dog was better than like the last four Dirt Dogs I had. For some reason, it was just perfect. So if I'm not feeling the poker, it's probably not a good idea to play the poker. My intention was to go over to Bellagio and play 1-3. But now, so the question now is, what do I do? It has been my intention for some time to get back on the daily vlogs the way that I once did them. In other words, without fail. I was never without fail 7 days a week, except for those 70, 75, 77, whatever it was in a row that I did that one time. But I mean, it's been difficult. I remember mentioning that I was gonna talk a little more about how the pandemic has affected my life. And then I sort of just let that idea fade into the background. But honestly, the pandemic has taken its toll. It's taken its toll on my bankroll. It's taken its toll on my life roll. I keep looking in the screen, not at myself, but to see who's behind me, who's walking up on me, and what's going on back there. And yes, I see the dude. I don't know, you can't even see him. Hold up. That dude. Sleep. I hope I don't wake him up. I don't want to startle him. You know what I mean? I mean, I am just inside his bedroom. But yeah, I had sort of slacked off of the vlogs when Lady Trooper and I first moved in together. And it was never my intention to slack off. But like I told you before, there were some adjustments to be made. There was some adjusting to do. Waking up not solo is very different from what I was used to. And so after a few months of adjusting to that, the new year came about and I was just gearing up to really start focusing on poker and focusing on the vlogs again. Next thing you know, it's coronavirus time. That shit has been almost a year now. Almost a year. So, as you know, it ruined my relationship with New Harvest Poker. New Harvest Poker. New Harvest Coffee. So Go Gamble Blend went away, which we've rectified that now. But then the casinos closed. I mean, really? The casinos closed down. And then when they opened back, the poker rooms weren't open. Weeks and eventually months went by. The vlogs suffered. Poker suffered, Las Vegas has suffered, just like everyone has suffered. And I know that I have it much better than a lot of people. 99.999% sure I had coronavirus, and I know that I had it better than some people. Some people died. Some people went on ventilators. Some people got really sick. I already explained to you what happened to me and Christina.
I want to take a nap.
Tyler, you're going to work, bitch.
I already explained what happened to me, as far as that goes, and Lady Trooper. It's really affected everything. The vibe and the mood of Vegas is different. The vlog has been different. Poker has definitely been different. But as months go by, and I'm not doing my thing, and earning the income the way that I normally do, shit has gotten a little bit tight. I'm not gonna lie. So I've been refocusing, and now, I mean, obviously, things are not back to normal yet, and I don't know when things will be back to normal. I believe in freedom as well as personal responsibility. So, I am responsible for myself. I'm responsible for my bankroll. I'm responsible for my income. I'm responsible for my vlog, my YouTube channel, everything. So, Trooper Thursday went down. We didn't even mention that. Westgate closed for a long time, and then after they opened, they didn't even reopen the poker room, and then you know, Trooper Thursday has suffered greatly because even though we're back up and running, we only get, you know, one table. Sometimes there's only one, or one time there was zero people from out of town. So Trooper Thursday doesn't last as long. As you well know, that's how I make my living. YouTube, Trooper Thursday, coffee, and go gamble hats and stuff. And so it's all suffered. But I, being the survivor that I always have been, believing in my own personal responsibility for myself, fully intend to get everything back in shape. The experience of moving here and getting to where I was has been the most rewarding time of my life. Bar none. Remember how I explained on the live stream the other day what bar means? Pass line and don't pass bar 12 or don't pass bar 2. Remember we talked about that? It's not the don't pass bar. It's the don't pass barring one particular roll. Back to the point. Barring nothing, bar none, the most rewarding experience of my life was moving here and creating what I did create from nothing. Starting the poker vlogs, starting Vegas daily vlogging, basically. And all you guys watching the videos, cheering me on, leaving comments, you know, wearing Go Gamble hats and drinking Go Gamble blend and all of those things, and sending me, you know, Starbucks mugs in the mail and all of that stuff. Most rewarding time of my life. So to watch that sort of dwindle during the last year has been somewhat painful, quite painful indeed. Creating all of this from nothing, all by myself, is just like the most rewarding thing ever. When I moved to the previous Casa del Trooper out of Desert Manor into Elysian West, basically from that day, it was like, wow, I'm not rich. I can't afford to, you know, burn money or anything like that, but I have worked my nuts off and continue to work my nuts off to be able to wake up every day on my terms and go to bed every night on my terms and never have to clock in, never have to check with the boss or do anything because I became the boss. So this has been the best thing that I've ever done in my entire life. And I do not intend to allow coronavirus or anything else, I don't intend to let any of them stop it. Nobody is going to stop the Trooper. Nobody is going to stop Go Gamble. Nothing stops the gamble. Thank you. So remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos and leave a comment down below. All this unfinished business, oh, we're about to handle it. I'll see you next time.